A couple miles north of Gull Lake, you'll find a gem hidden among the cornfields.
People fell in love with it.
Falling in love with nostalgia at a place where past meets the present.
Telling people the stories, all have great stories.
And for Jay Follis, stories aren't good stories unless they're about cars.
The Model T was an automobile in the very early part of the auto industry. Henry Ford started in 1903. And by 1908, he had created a car that was pretty inexpensive, very easy to operate, and was designed for the everyman.
Follis seems to know it all.
Called a rumble seat.
He kind of has to, working at the Gilmar Car Museum, a building housing one of North America's largest collections of classic and vintage automobiles. Many of those Model Ts, the car Follis says changed the world.
That's when people started traveling. They would leave where they lived. They could take a job someplace because now they could drive 20 miles to work.
Henry Ford, manufacturing the Model T from 1908 to 1927. It was unlike any car made today.
There's no gas pedal. There's no real stick shift.
No heat, AC, or odometers. Just a pedal to go forward, backward, and for the brake.
Anybody could get into this car and figure out how to drive it.
Well,
all the way down.
Oh, I stalled it.
Anyone might be a stretch.
All right.
This is a 1919 Model T Depot hack.
Way down, there you go.
It's one of the cars instructors here at the Gilmar Car Museum are teaching people to drive.
Each class runs about, say, 3.5-4 hours.
It's driver's ed with a blast from the past.
Put your brake on.
The Model T Driving School, getting its start 9 years ago. Instructors teaching 1,500 people, ranging from age 16 to 93.
In this class, you're gonna learn how to not just drive the car, but you're gonna learn why it was important.
A class like none other, featuring a relic of the road. Near Gull Lake, Erica Francis, Fox 17 News.